Shraddha and welcome to Hindu Mythology World. In our previous video, Nar Narayan Part 1, we have seen that how Arjuna failed to help Brahman. If you haven't seen that video, the link is in the description and in the eye icon. Today, we are going to see what happened next. Did really Arjuna burn himself? So, let's start. When Arjuna failed to save the Brahmana's baby, he decided to burn himself there. But Krishna stopped him. Before you take such a drastic step, there is something you must see, Krishna said. With his magical powers, Krishna built a chariot. Then Arjuna sat in the chariot and Krishna took hold on the reins of the chariot. After some time, Arjuna realized that the wheels of the chariot were no longer on the ground. The chariot was flying high and high in the sky. It was a long journey. The chariot had left the mountains and the rivers behind. Soon, the chariot was crossing the sea. Everything was blur. The sky whizzed past as the speed increased. Krishna looked straight ahead. The sky became so dark that the stars could not be seen. Krishna released his Sudarshan Chakra. Then the Sudarshan Chakra glowed very brightly and this helped them to find their way. Now they were over the another ocean of fresh water, full of serpents and large fishes and strange magical creatures. Then they passed another ocean full of fire. That ocean had fiery reptiles. And finally, the sea of milk. At the center of sea of milk, Arjuna saw something amazing. There was someone sitting on a large serpent. The serpent was having 1,000 hoods. That person was having 4 arms, in which he held a cow shell, a Sudarshan Chakra, a mace and a lotus. He had a gentle smile on his face. Then Arjuna realized that person was none other than God Vishnu himself. At Vishnu's feet sat Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth and fortune. On Vishnu's tongue sat Saraswati, the goddess of wisdom. The serpent was Adi Anant Shesh, the serpent of time. This was God, who sustained the rhythm of cosmos. The God who can fold the time and can do impossible things. When Arjuna and Krishna arrived there, Arjuna prostrated Vishnu. Arjuna noticed that Vishnu had babies in his arms. Krishna smiled and says to Arjuna, "These are the babies of Brahman. The God can make babies disappear without any human being. This means that the things that did not exist in human imagination, that things exist in the imagination of God." God Vishnu said, "I brought these babies here so that you follow them and learn the true purpose of your existence." Arjuna didn't understand. Then Krishna explained, "Once you were Nar and I was Narayana. Together we fought many demons and won many battles. Now we are Arjuna and Krishna. We have been created to restore Dharma on earth." Vishnu told Arjuna, "Krishna is wisdom and you are the action. Without each other, you are useless. All your battles you will win only when you are together." This is how Arjuna knew the importance of Krishna and the purpose of his life.
Never miss any updates from Hindu Mythology World, subscribe to the channel and press press the notification bell icon.